Hey, are you guys having any fun yet? Okay, good. I wanted you to know we can, even though we don't have a lot of money, we can still throw a pretty good party.
Good news at last for Republicans in the great state of Minnesota. Quite a few state Republican parties have been keeping the national party leadership awake at night with their financial troubles recently. But Minnesota has been the brokest state Republican party of all. They entered the presidential election season $1 million in debt. Things, in fact, got so bad for Minnesota Republicans that they were nearly evicted from their headquarters last month. The party had not paid the rent in months. They owed $96,000 to their landlord. This month, they reached some sort of confidential deal with that landlord so they would not get kicked out. An attorney for the landlord did say publicly that the deal comes with an or else clause, as in the Republicans have to make the rent for a change every month now, or else. But money has not been the only headache the Minnesota Republicans have been causing their party elders in Washington this year. At their caucuses in February, Minnesota Republicans rejected Mitt Romney and picked Rick Santorum instead. Mr. Romney didn't even get second place in the Minnesota caucuses. That went to Ron Paul. Mitt Romney came in third. But you know, that was back in February. That's all over now. Now Rick Santorum is out and Mitt Romney is the de facto nominee. Even Ron Paul says he's no longer competing in the various primaries, like the ones tonight in Arkansas and Kentucky. Now the party is coming together. Now the Republican Party is one for all and all for Mitt Romney, right? Not in Minnesota. Minnesota Republicans had their convention this weekend with 13 delegates at stake. They gave 12 of their 13 delegates to Ron Paul. They would have given him all 13 of their delegates, except that one Ron Paul supporter stepped aside so a delegate for Michelle Bachmann could have that spot, which was nice. But Minnesota Republicans this weekend, 13 delegates up for grabs, 12 to Ron Paul, 1 to Michelle Bachmann, 0 to Mitt Romney. Imagine what the conversations are like right now between the Minnesota Republicans and the Romney campaign, between the state and the National Republican Party. Yeah, we're still going with Ron Paul here. While I got you on the phone, can you possibly help us out with some rent money? But I did say there is some good news for Minnesota Republicans here, and that is that the state Republicans, with their $96,000 due in back rent and their $1 million debt, the state Republican Party in Minnesota did find a way to turn the popularity of Ron Paul into more than just something that gets them in trouble with the guys at National. They turned Ron Paul's triumphant visit to their convention this weekend into a fundraiser for the state Republican Party. Lemons into lemonade. If you can't beat them, join them. And good luck winning Minnesota in November, Mitt Romney. If you need any help at the state level, perhaps hire your own.